Before we get started, this video was of course shot before social distancing was put into place. So stay home, stay safe, and of course, huge shout out to our sponsor, Micro Center, for their wonderful online store, which is available at the link in the description. Enjoy, guys.
Hello and welcome to our wonderful sponsor, Micro Center, here in Tustin, California, where I have a very simple challenge. So at this point, you've likely seen our coverage of the Xbox Series X. Well, today, I am going to build the closest gaming PC I can to give us a good sense of what the Series X will look like when it goes on sale later this year. One of the most important components is definitely the processor, which is why we're going with the Ryzen 7 3700X. This is pretty much exactly what you will find inside the Series X. You've got the same Zen 2 core architecture, the same 8-core design. This should give us a very good sense of the performance. Next up, we have the Aorus X570i Pro Wi-Fi. Now, not only will this fit in our case, which I'll show you in a minute, but the cool thing is we have all the features we need, and it will fully support our Ryzen 7 3700X. And all the other things we're doing. Am I too close right now? Is this uncomfortable for you to have to focus the camera this close? We're also taking advantage of a 1 TB Aorus PCIe Gen 4 SSD. Now this is about as close as we're going to get to what's inside the Xbox Series X. They obviously have a custom SSD, but we are taking advantage of PCIe Gen 4, and this is about as fast as it gets on the PC space right now. Next up, we're taking advantage of some G-Skill Trident Z Neo memory. Now this is great for Ryzen builds. We've used it a couple times in the past, and it should be plenty fast for all the Xboxing we're about to do. Can I use Xboxing as a verb? I don't think I can. That sounds stupid.
Probably not.
Okay, I won't do that anymore. And so with our Gigabyte Radeon 5700 XT, we only really need one more thing. That's because we have this, the NZXT H1. So this is a brand new case which has a lot of similarities, shall we say, to the Xbox Series X. So you may have noticed when we were shopping for components, we left out a couple of crucial ones, including not only the case, but also our power supply and cooler. However, all of that actually comes built into the NZXT H1, which is why it is a little bit on the expensive side, but considering that we have a lot that's built into this guy, I feel like it's fairly justified. Come on, that's pretty close to the Series X size. Maybe it's a touch taller. Yeah, okay, it's a little taller. But besides that, that's pretty similar. So obviously there are some differences between this and the Series X. Not only does it have USB-C built in, you have a window. When you look around back, the components are, well, there's a lot built in here. So let's actually, let's figure out how to tear into this. Something interesting I'm seeing here, a lot of the cables have already been routed. This actually might be fairly easy to build into once we put our ITX board and everything inside. Okay, that's actually really interesting. So essentially we can completely expose the sort of skeleton of the case. So we have our power supply cables, some instructions on how to remove the panels, even though you have to do that to even get in here in the first place. Now, if you want a full tutorial on how to build a gaming PC, we actually did that a little while ago, which you guys can check out over here. But for now, let's build ourselves a Series X. You know, when it comes to building a small PC like this, especially in such a tiny case, it makes sense that you need a very small motherboard. Now, when it comes to an ITX board, which is also compatible with X570, you can see that there's a lot crammed in here. So not only do we have our chipset active cooler, but we don't really have a ton of space. We only have 2 DIMM slots, obviously. So for our SSD, we actually have some pretty solid cooling. So not only is it surrounded by this heatsink, but we actually have active cooling blowing directly on it, which should definitely help keep things cool. I feel good about this build, and especially considering how nicely this case is designed, I really can't wait to see once it's all put together how it actually performs. I feel like we actually can get close to the Series X. We're definitely going to be behind in some areas, but I think we actually might be able to get closer than pretty much any other PC build that you could get. I mean, it would be tough to get this level of performance in this small of a case. So of course, for our processor, we are taking advantage of the Ryzen 7 3700X. Now there are some very slight modifications inside the actual Xbox Series X chip itself. So they are using some slightly tweaked Zen 2 cores, but as far as I know, the performance should be almost identical. And because you have a couple of options on the Series X, so you can either run it with or without hyperthreading and at either 3.8 or 3.6 gigahertz, it should be super easy for us to lock the clock speed. And so should get the exact same CPU performance as the Series X is going to work with. Now, the memory itself is a little bit different than what we're getting on Series X. So with the Series X, we do have a combined 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory, and that serves not only the CPU, but also the graphics. In the PC space, you just don't do that. The graphics card always has its own memory, and the CPU obviously always has its own. So we're taking advantage of 16 gigs here. It's a little bit more than the Series X has, to be totally fair, but Windows does have more overhead, and realistically, none of the games that we're going to try are even going to take advantage of all this memory in the first place. It's very much more so of a more of a future-proofing thing for Series X. But as far as raw performance goes, I do think we should be in the right ballpark. So when it comes to the SSD, this is actually something which, it's a little bit of a mixed bag, because this technically is faster than what you get inside the Series X. So while these are both 1 terabyte drives, what we have here is something which is theoretically rated to up to 5 gigabytes per second, whereas the Xbox Series X tops out at 2.4 gigabytes. However, they have done a lot of tuning to make sure that it has a very consistent level of performance. Whether or not this will be able to hold up to 5 gigabytes per second for hours at a time, probably a little bit unlikely. Although actually with this cooler, it should help a lot. So I know Microsoft made a really big point about trying to make sure that the Series X SSD had the lowest level of latency possible to try to get, specifically when you're actually using it as a substitute for graphics memory. So because it only has 16 gigs, if you want to go more, and I'm assuming most developers will take advantage of this, you can actually take advantage of your SSD on the Series X to provide more graphics memory. That is not something that we can do on the PC. But with a very, very fast SSD on board, I do think we have a really good shot of at least simulating a lot of those load times that we get on the Series X. So I have installed the motherboard, the memory, everything is here. We have our all-in-one cooler, which you can't see because as soon as you close it up, it looks like a cabled mess. But what you will be able to see is where our graphics card is going to be vertically mounted. So that is where our 5700 XT comes in. Now, yes, I'm sure if you've watched our video about the Xbox Series X, you'll know that this is not quite as powerful as what you're getting in that system. Now it is of course AMD based and it is RDNA based, however this is RDNA 1.0 not 2.0, which means that we do lose things such as hardware ray tracing. Theoretically we could have put something like an RTX like 2070 or 2080 inside, but I wanted to try to keep this as close as possible. This is quite a large card. So I guess we just slot it in something like... Oh, wow. Yep, that fits. There we go. It's funny. So much of this case is designed around trying to cram as many components in this tiny space as possible. And then you have the GPU, which is literally like half the size of the case. So with that, of course, we'll have all our ports on the bottom, but we pretty much have the guts of our Xbox Series X. Now I just need to put all the windows and the case panels on and see exactly what this guy is capable of. I gotta say, that actually looks pretty cool, though. So let's see just how powerful our Xbox Series X PC is. Now, of course, standard disclaimer here, while our CPU and generally speaking, the overall configuration is similar to the Xbox Series X, the graphics specifically are not as powerful. So one of the best ways to put this head to head is with literally the only game that I know, not only the performance, but also the actual spec of, which is Gears 5 running on the Xbox Series X. So why don't we actually see if we can get the settings as close as possible and see if there's actually a massive difference. This will not be as powerful, but I'm curious if we can actually hit a stable 4K 60 maxed out. Why can't I click on settings? Oh, you actually have to hit, oh, you have to open a stupid menu, okay. I didn't have ultra textures installed.
Oh, I didn't even know that was a thing.
Okay, well, I'm 61% complete on installing my ultra textures. I wonder how long that's gonna take. With our ultra textures installed, let's give this a try. So for reference, the Xbox Series X runs everything at 4K, 60 frames per second, with full ultra settings and a couple of additional settings that are simply just not available in the standard PC release. So right now we are not there. So 4K ultra, we're getting about 36 FPS. All right, so our grand total is 38.9 FPS. So it's not totally crazy considering the Series X is around 60, but it really does just go to show how optimized that Xbox Series X is and how much of a beast it is. Because when you look at this system, which I don't even know how much the grand total of this was, definitely double if not more than what the Series X costs, you're getting a lot of performance. The CPU is capped at 209 frames per second. The GPU is capped at 39. Like, it goes to show just how much headroom these Zen 2 cores have. I'm very, very excited to see what the Series X looks like when we get our hands on it. But when it comes to this PC, sure, it might not be as powerful as the console, but I've got to say it looks really nice. My biggest issue with it really is just the fact that with this window up front, it's not the most aesthetically pleasing thing in the world. And cable management, considering that all of the runs are pretty much pre-populated, where there's really just nothing for you to do, means that it's not the prettiest looking thing in the world. However, I will say if you're looking to build yourself a tiny gaming PC, just turn it this way and tell everyone you got yourself a Series X early. Is that what anyone wants? Does anyone want to pretend their PC is a Series X? Okay, that's not the case. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Definitely be sure to check out all the components we used and our wonderful sponsor, Micro Center, in the link in the description. Until next time, I'm going to go wait until I get my hands on an actual Series X and stop making clickbait videos about it.
You already did.
I know, but I've got at least a few more clickbait videos before the Series X actually comes out.